I hope you all are safe and fine. Stay home, stay safe, stay safe. Very critical situation outside, and take prevention for this COVID-19. I am doing the same thing what you are doing also. Now, today, let's start the next part of the lines and angles. Lines and angles. That is, the lines and a transversal. The lines and a transversal. So now, let's start it. I have drawn a figure for you. See, the figure is having one line that is called as M and another line that is called as N. So two lines are there. I am not saying that they are parallel, but these are two lines there, M line and N line, intersected by one another line that is called as L. So L line is intersecting the M line and the N line in two points, these two distinct points, that is P and Q. After intersecting the M and N lines, what you are observing today is the discussion point. Now you see, I wrote here, observe the figure. At how many points L line meets the other two lines? How many points this L line is meeting the M and N line in two points very clearly, that is P and Q. The L line meets the other two lines in two distinct points, that is called P and Q. So line L is called as a transversal. So what is this L line is called as? This L line is called as a transversal. Why? When a line is intersecting another two lines in two distinct points, then the line is said to be the transversal for the other two lines. Understood now? What is transversal? Transversal means a line which is intersecting the other two lines at two distinct points is called as a transversal. That one I wrote here. So here I said the line L meets the other two lines in two distinct points, that is P and Q. So line L is called as a transversal. So L line is called as a transversal for M and N lines. Understood. Now you see, observe the figure again and observe the angle formed when a transversal intersects a pair of lines. So these are two pair of lines, M and N. And see now, what is the point to observe? When this L line, that means the transversal, is intersecting these two lines at two different distinct points, how many angles are going to form? Here very clearly I showed you angle number 1, angle number 2, angle number 3, angle number 4, here 5, 6, 7 and 8. So all in total we got 8 angles. When a transversal is intersecting to a pair of lines, 8 angles are going to be formed. So here it is written that when a transversal intersects a pair of lines, if a transversal meets two lines, we get 8 angles. We get 8 angles. That means when a transversal intersects a pair of lines, we get 8 angles. And it intersects the other pair of lines in two distinct points. Then only this line is called as, L line is called as the transversal line. I hope you understood this part now. Now come to the next part of this. What is that? From the given figure, what is your observing? Angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. Angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Similarly, angle 5 is opposite to angle 7. And angle 6 is opposite to angle 8. I wrote it here. The types of angles formed when a transversal is intersecting two lines in two distinct points. So what are the angles formed? So angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Opposite angles. Then similarly, angle 5 is equal to angle 7. 6 equal to 8. And these are all also called opposite angles. Next you see, 4 angle is equal to 6 angle. 4 angle is equal to 6 angle. So these two are called as alternate interior angles, because they are in the interior of the line. So they are called as alternate interior angles. So now you see, what is alternate interior angles? 4 angle equal to 6 angle. 4 angle equal to 6 angle. And 3 angle is equal to 5 angle. So they are called as alternate interior angles. Similarly, 1 angle is equal to 7 angle. See now, 1 angle equal to 7 angle. These two are alternate also. And 2 angle is equal to 8 angle. And they are alternate exterior angles. They are called as alternate exterior angles. 4 and 6 are called as alternate interior angles, whereas 1 and 7, 2 and 8 are called as alternate exterior angles. I wrote it here, alternate exterior angles. So these are my observations. Now you see another thing, very important thing. See, the angle 4, 5, 3, 6 are the interior angles of same side. Angle 3, 4, 5, 6, they are called as the interior angle. 3 and 6 are the same side, and 4 and 5 are in the same side. So they are called interior angles on same side. Interior angles on same side. I hope you understood it. Next, we are going to go for the next part. Now come to the next point. What is the next point? And the interior or exterior angles, or this interior and exterior angles can be called as co-interior or co-exterior angles, or can be called as allied interior or allied exterior angles. So interior and exterior angles are there. When they will be called as co-interior or co-exterior, when they will be called as allied interior and allied exterior, this is the point of discussion now. Now you see, I just draw a figure here. Here MI, MA is a line and N is a line, and there is the transversal is L. Now L is intersecting the M and N in P and Q points. And here 8 angles are created, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See now on the left hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4 angles are there. And in right hand side, 5, 6, 7, 8 angles are there. So in left hand side 4 angles, and in right hand side 4 angles are there. Now clearly you see 1, 5, 4, 8 are called as the exterior angles. Called as the exterior angles. Clear? So that one I want to explain you. 1, 5, 4, 8 are the exterior angles. 2, 3, 6, 7 are the interior angles. Clear? So 4 exterior angles, 4 interior angles. But when this exterior angle or interior angle can be called as the co-exterior angle and allied angle? Let's see. Now you see, observe the figure. What are the exterior angles on the same side of the transversal? Very easy. Clearly 1, 4, 5, 8. 1, 4, 5, 8 are the exterior angles. But you see, in the same side of the transversal, in the same side of the transversal, how many exterior angles are there? Exterior angles. There are only 2 exterior angles are there, 1 and 4. So these 2 exterior angles in the same side of the transversal are called as the co-exterior, allied, sorry, here it is co-exterior, you have to write here co-exterior, 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 or allied exterior. You have to say 1 and 4 due to they are present in the same side of the transversal and they are exterior angles. For that reason, they are called as co-exterior or allied exterior. Clear? Here it is co-interior or allied interior you have to write. Pardon me, allied interior. Interior. Clear now? Now you see, when this interior and exterior, angles, I hope you understood. Four are exterior angles and four interior angles are there when there are two lines intersected by one transversal. In two distinct points, 8 angles are created. Among them, 4 are exterior and 4 are interior angles. Then when the interior angles should be co-interior or allied interior, and when the exterior angle will be said as co-exterior or allied exterior. I explained you, if they are present in the same side, so look, exterior angle 1 and 4, 5 and 8 are called exterior angle. But 1 and 4 is present just in the same side of the transversal, 1 and 4. For that reason, they are called as co-exterior or allied exterior. Understood now? So, exterior angles on the same side of a transversal are called co-exterior or allied exterior angles. Now, I hope you understood what is 1 and 4. 1 and 4 are called as the co-exterior or allied exterior angles. Now, you see, similarly, how many interior angles are produced? 2, 3, 6, 7, 4 interior angles are there. Now 2, 3, see 2, 3, the position of 2, 3, it is in the same side of the transversal. So these two are interior angles, but that can be called as the allied interior angles or co-interior angles. And 5, 6, 7 also in the right hand side, the position is right hand side. So they are called as the allied interior or co-interior angles. So 2, 3 and 6, 7 are called as the co-interior or allied interior angles. And 1, 4 and 5, 8 are called as the co-exterior or allied exterior angles. Here it is written, observe the figure. What are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal? Clearly 2, 3, 6, 7. So 2, 3. 2, 3 are in the same side. 6, 7 are in the same side. So 2, 3 are called as interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Same side of the transversal are called co-interior or allied interior angles. I hope you understood it nicely. So exterior interior angles, very easy to understand. Which are in outside, those are called exterior. Which are inside, those are called the interior angles. But again, this interior can be called as co-interior, and when it will be called as co-interior and allied interior, when they are in the same side of the transversal, they can call as co-interior or allied interior. Similarly, if they are in the same side and they are exterior also, they can call be as co-exterior or allied exterior angles. I hope you understood this idea. After that, related theorem is there for you. I will go for that. Now come to the next part. What is the next part? There is a theorem for you that is called theorem 4.2 in your book, but don't go for this 4.2. Please try to remember the statement of the theorem. You have to prove this theorem in your note. How I am doing? See now, when you are writing a theorem, first of all you write the statement. What is the statement given to you? First of all, you have to write the statement. The statement will come in the question paper. So don't worry, just you remember the statement by which you can able to do the answer in the answer note. Now you see what is written. If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then each pair of alternate angles are equal. So I hope you understood what is a transversal. What is a transversal? A line which is just intersecting the other two lines in two distinct points is called as a transversal. So if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, so these two lines are parallel, it is given. M line is parallel to N line, and this is the transversal, that is L line. Intersecting the two lines in two distinct points, that is called P and Q. I hope you understood. Then each pair of alternate angles, we have to see what are the alternate angles here. You see, for that reason, I draw my figure. There is a after statement. The figure is given to you. Figure number 1, figure number 2 and figure number 3. Like that, you have to draw 3 figures separately. Then, you have to go for your namings. LM line, N line and this L line. These are the points of intersection P and Q. After that, you have to see what are the alternate angles. Look at it. I said you, there are two pairs of alternate angles, exterior alternate angles and interior alternate angles. So now you see exterior alternate, this is this one, let it be angle number 1, let it be angle number 1. So angle number 1 and angle number 7, see now, these two are called as exterior alternate angles. These two are called as exterior alternate angles. And 3 and 6, they are in the inside the parallel line. So these two are called as 3 and 6, 3 and 6, these two are called as the interior alternate angles. I hope you understood. Similarly, in all the figures, I did it and I gave my namings and my intersection points, and I show my alternate exterior angles and alternate interior angles as 1 and 7 and 3 and 6. 1 and 7 and 3 and 6 are the interior alternate angles, and 1 and 7 are the exterior alternate angles in 3 figures. Then after that, what you have to do, see now, you have to RTP. What is the RTP? RTP. RTP means write to prove. What you have to prove? You have to prove angle 1 equal to angle 7 and angle 3 equal to angle 6. That much you have to prove. To show that angle 1 equal to angle 7 and angle 3 must be equal to angle 6. That alternate exterior, that means 1 and 7, and alternate interior, that is 3 and 6 are same. That one you are going to prove now. So how to prove? See now, proof, after that proof, so this will be in one line, this hyphens will be in one line, and all the things will be written in one side. All the figures will be drawn nicely, and after that there is an observation table. I did a observation table. So what is this observation table? Look at it. In first column, I wrote figure. Figure 1, figure 2 and figure 3. I wrote it here. Figure 1, figure 2, figure 3. In figure 1, what is my angle number 1? What is my angle number 7? In figure 2 also, what is my angle number 1, 7? 1, 7 in figure number 3. So I wrote angle 1, angle 7, then angle 3 and angle 6. Angle 3 and angle 6, these two are interior alternate. Angle 1 and 7 are the exterior alternate. Then I wrote a relation. What is the relation between them? So I saw angle 1 is equal to angle 7. In relation, first one I measure the MPL angle is giving you 100 degree. And when I measure this one, let it be A and Q. This is Q. A, Q, let it be P. A, Q, P angle. That means 7 number angle. Angle number 7 is also coming 100 degree. Then I conclude that angle 1 is equal to angle 7 in the relation column. In the relation column, I showed angle 1 equal to angle 7 and angle 3 equal to angle 6 because both angles are coming 80 degree to me. Okay, so now it is the relation are same. Then what is your remark? There will be a remark column. Please do a quick table like this in your note and also try to prove as I proof. So now it is alternate angles are equal. What are the remark? Alternate angles are equal. Then in the both the figure, I got the same remark what I got in the first figure. Clear? Understood now? After that, what you have to conclude? This is the conclusion. What is the conclusion? Now, from the above observation, we conclude that. What do you conclude? We conclude that alternate exterior, interior angles are equal. That means alternate exterior angle as well as the alternate interior angles are equal. So, this statement is proved now. So, this is a theorem. You have to go for the theorem. Like I did here, you have to go like that. By doing three figures and going for observation table and showing your alternate exterior and alternate interior angles and mark the relation between them. Then what is your remark? You got. Then after that, you go for the conclusion that alternate angles may be exterior, may be interior are equal. Now, come to the next theorem. Next part. What is the next part? Next part is related to the, before I said the about the interior angles. For interior angles, there is a theorem provided to you that is called theorem 4.3. Forget this 4.3. It is a theorem for you. So go for the statement of the theorem first. What is the statement? The statement is, I said you how to write the theorem. So statement, then figure, then RTP, then proof. So it should be in one line. Now what is the theorem? If a transversal intersects two parallel lines, each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal, on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Supplementary means two right angles, that is 180 degree. So, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, so these two are parallel lines, M and N, so transversal is L. In three figures, I did three figures for you by showing the two lines M and N parallel to each other. And here is the transversal, and M and N is the parallel lines, and here is the transversal. So in these three figures, this transversal L is intersecting the M and N, M line and N line at P and Q point in two distinct points. Then what is it? Then each pair of interior angles. So interior angles on same side. Look, this is one side, that is one side. So this is left side, that is right side. In left side, what are the interior angles for you? 2 and 3 for left side. And for right side, the interior angles are 4 and 5. I showed it in the figure. That means angle 2, angle 3 are in left side interior angles, co-interiors, and 4 and 5 are co-interiors. Just right now I said about co-interiors or allied interiors. So allied interiors is 4 and 5, 2 and 3. In left hand side and right hand side, 4 and 5 are allied interiors. In each figure, it is like that. Now it is understandable. Next you come to the point to prove. What you have to prove? You have to prove each pair of interior angles, these two pairs, 2 and 3, on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. You have to prove now angle 2 plus angle 3 is supplementary. That means 180 degree. Two right angles, angle 2 plus angle 3 will give you 180 degree or two right angles. Similarly, 4 and 5, angle plus 4, angle 5 equal to 180 degree. It must give to you in the right hand side the allied interior angles. Now come to the point, proof. RTP, after the two proof, there is the proof. How to prove? I draw out the observation table for you, like before theorem. What is that? I took some figures, 1, 2, 3 figures. Then I showed my angles, the interior angles, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5. Then I wrote what is the relation between the sum, because he says to each pair of interior angles on the same side. So what is the relation between 2 plus 3? I want to show. And what is the relation between 4 plus 5? I want to show. So now I got my measurement as angle 2. You measure in protractor and see the angle 2 measurement and angle 3 measurement. I wrote here 140, that is 70 and 110. And 4 and 5, if it is 70, then definitely it will be 110 degree, no need to measure. Because these two are linear pair angles, 2 plus 4 must be equal to 180 degree. So if it is 70, then it will come 110 degree. Then if it is 110, then it will come 70. Because this is 70, so this is 110, so this will be 70. So definitely, I got my 4 and 5 angles also. Now I want to show the relation between the each pair of interior angles, that is angle 2 plus angle 3, how much? It gave me 110 plus 70, that is 180. Angle 4 and 5 also gave me 110 plus 70, 180 degree. One for one figure I did it, all other figures you have to do it. Now what is the remark? Remark is the sum of the each of pair of the interior angles of the same side of a transversal are supplementary. That means two right angles. So now we are on the conclusion part. What is the conclusion part? See, from the above observation, what you observe? It is clear that the sum of the each pair of interior angles, sum of the each pair of interior angles on the same side of a transversal, on the same side, again I am repeating, same side of a transversal, left hand side or right hand side, 2 plus 3 or 4 plus 5, same side of the transversal are supplementary, though they are giving you 180 degree. I hope you understood it. So what I did, I write my statement first. The statement is, you have to draw a transversal and give two parallel lines also, and I took three figures for that, and you have to show the each pair of interior angles in the figure, that is in the left hand side is 2, 3, right hand side is 4, 5. Then what I did, I want to prove it. What is my proof? This same side interior, each pair of interior angles will be 180 degree. So 2 plus 3 will be 180 and 4 plus 5 will be 180 degree. So this is under RTP column, RTP. This is under figure column. Then the proof is, by observation table, we can take three figures, write my all the interior angles, pair of interior angles near side by side. Then I have to show what is the relation between them. They are giving you 180 degree. And therefore, that is it. I conclude that from the observation, I am clear that the sum of the each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. I hope you understood it. Come to the next part. Next part is also a theorem for you. Theorem 4.4. Forget about this 4.4. Go to the theorem statement now. What is the statement? I said you statement, figure, given, right to prove, proof will be in the same series. So this theorem, the statement of the theorem is, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines such that the pair of alternate interior alternate angles are equal, it is given that alternate interior angles are equal for you, then the two lines are parallel. So I draw the figure according to the statement. So AB and CD are two parallel lines intersected by the transversal PS in the two distinct point Q1R. What is given to you? The given is that the pair of alternate interior angles are equal. The pair of alternate angles are equal. That is given to you. So given is, on the above figure, PS intersects AB and CD. AB and CD at two distinct points, that is called Q1R points. So what is given to you? Now, what is that? Two pair alternate interior angle. What are the alternate interior? This and this interior. What is that? BQR angle is equal to QRC. So this one, these two angles are equal, it is given to you. It is given. So it is given to you. What do we have to prove? Right to prove is AB parallel to CD. AB line will be parallel to CD line. That one we have to prove it. Similarly, you see proof. What is the proof? Now, BQR angle. What is BQR? BQR. This angle is equal to this angle. Why? Because both are vertically opposite. Both are vertically opposite. I understood. You all understood it. I hope you all understood it. So BQR, this angle is equal to PQA, this angle. So these two angles are what? Vertically opposite angle. So BOA. Clear? So this BQR angle is equal to PQA angle. It is given. Now you see, in the given, what is given? BQR again is equal to QRC. So you can write BQR equal to QRC. Let it be question number 2. It is given. It is vertically opposite. So look at this, say BQR same is equal to PQA, BQR angle equal to QRC angle. So these two angles are same. So these two angles are also same. What is that? From 1 and 2, equation 1 and equation 2, what you got? You got angle PQA. PQA angle is equal to QRC angle. QRC angle. Please see from the figure, what is PQA angle? PQA, this angle, is equal to QRC, QRC, this angle. These two angles are equal. But you see, what are these two angles called as? These two angles are called as corresponding angles. These two angles are same now. So definitely the corresponding angles are same. On which case? When the two lines are parallel to each other. When the two lines will be parallel to each other, then only the corresponding angles will be equal. That is coming here. I wrote it here, you see. But they are corresponding angles. Due to they are corresponding angles, PQA angle is equal to QRC angle. Both are the corresponding angles. They due to the corresponding angles, on which case these corresponding angles will be same? Definitely when the two lines will be parallel. So AB is parallel to CD. So AB is parallel to CD. Here we proved what our given proof is. AB is parallel to CD. Now we proved it. That is AB is parallel to CD. So it is very easy theorem for you, but you have to understand the statement nicely. Then only according to that you have to do your figure, what is the required figure. After required figure, you have to write the given nicely, what is given in the statement. Then we are going to go for the what to prove. Then the proof will start. The proof is that very easy proof. Again, I am saying to you, so look at it. It is given that this angle is equal to this angle. BQR is equal to QRC. These two are equal. It is given. Now we have to prove this line is parallel to this line. How? Now you see in our these two are opposite angles. BQR angle is opposite to PQA angle. So these two angles are same. But this is equation number 1. Let it be VOA. Vertically opposite angles. Then what is our given? BQR angle equal to QRC. BQR angle equal to QRC. That is equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, BQR is this much, BQR is this much. So these two are equal. So now 1 and 2, we got this angle is equal to this angle. So what is this angle? This one. And what is this angle QRC? QRC, these two angles are equal now. On which case it will be equal? They are corresponding. Then on which case they will be equal? When the two lines will be parallel to each other. Then AB parallel to CD. I hope you understood it. Come to the next part. Next part, I from 99 angles, I did a related sums. The related sum I am just explaining you. I took a very critical figure here and I am explaining that sum to you. Right? I hope you will understand it nicely. See now. In the adjacent figure, there is a figure for you. Find the value of X, Y, Z and A, B, C. Find the value of X, Y, Z, A, B, C. And some values are given to you, 110 and 65 degree here. Clear now? So, how to go for this? How to find out the value of X, Y, Z, A, B, C when the given values are given, two values are given to us only. See now, I started it clearly. We have Y angle is given to us. Y angle, look at it. He is saying my angle equal to 110 degree. Y angle is not direct Y angle we can get. See now, this is a line, transversal this one, So now you see, this is the transversal. Don't be confused by this transversal and this transversal. So here it is the line, here it is the line, here it is the line. So now the transversal is this one. So now look, these two angles in red mark I am showing, these two angles are, because this is a transversal now, so these two angles are called as corresponding angles. So 110 degree is y straightforward from the figure, very easy. Y angle equal to 110 degree. So y angle equal to 110 degree, that is the corresponding angle. You have to write the reason for that, why it is 110 degree. So you got the y angle. Then he is saying x angle plus y angle is 180 because they are linear pair. See now, x and y. So yes, this is a linear pair angles. This and this. These two pairs are linear. These two pairs are linear. Linear pair. So definitely, this is the line and this is the line standing on that. So x plus y must be equal to 180 degree. That is written. And putting the y value here. What is the y value? 110. Taking to that side, 180 minus 110, that is 70 degrees x. So x value is coming 70 degree. Now you got two values. This is 70 degree and this is 110 degree. You already got it. Now come to the next point, that is z. See the z. Z angle equal to x angle. Again corresponding. See, these two lines are parallel to each other. And this is the transversal. Here x and z. Both two angles are corresponding. Because this is the parallel line. This is the transversal. So x, z are corresponding angles. X, z are corresponding angles. So x angle is 70. Clearly y, z angle is equal to 70 degree. Very easy. Clear? Now you see, z angle equal to x angle is 70 degree. Corresponding angles, we got it. Now come to the point. C angle is 65 degree. He is saying C angle will be 65 degree. Now we can you say me why C angle is 65? Why this angle is 65 degree? Why C angle? See now. C angle. What is saying C angle? C angle is 65. Why C angle is 65? This angle is equal to this angle. 65. He is saying 65 means this angle must be equal to this angle. So now it is 65 degree. So what is the reason to that? What is the reason? Because they are forming a similar triangle here. So this angle must be equal to this angle. So this C angle is equal to 65 degree. Now A angle plus C angle. See, this is the line. A angle and C angle. A angle and C angle. C angle it comes 65 degree. Understood now? Due to this is a triangle and this is a triangle. So here we are going for similarity. We are getting it. Now it is C. If it is 110, then this angle will be warmer, 70 degree. This angle will be 70. Clear now? Now, this angle is 65. So, what will be this angle? 180 minus 70 plus 65, that is 135. Then, after minus, this angle will come. No need of this angle. Now, you see, C angle is 65. We got C angle equal to 65. Now, A angle plus C angle is equal to 180. Why linear pair? A angle plus C angle is equal to 180 because these two are linear pair. So C angle is 65 means A angle is 180 minus 65. How much it is? 115 degree. So we got the A angle as 115 degree. Now you see C angle is opposite to B angle. C angle is opposite to B angle. Vertical opposite. B angle equal to C angle 60 degree because they are vertically opposite. So these two are vertically opposite. B angle and C angle. So this is equal to also 65 degree. Understood now? Now you see, here another format I am putting here also. You see, look at this line and this line. This is the transversal. So the angles, this one must be equal to this one. This also called as the corresponding angles. If you cannot understand the similarity also for triangle, don't go for that. This line and this line, three parallel lines are there divided by one. What is that? Transversal. So this angle must be equal to this angle, that is called corresponding angles. So C angle is equal to 65 degree also. Here now A angle plus C angle is 180 degree linear pair. So 180 minus 65, 115 degree A angle. Now C angle opposite is B angle because they are vertically opposite. So B angle and C angle both are same, that is 65 degree vertically opposite. So from here we got all the angles, that is A, B, C, X, Y, Z nicely. So, like that, this type of critical figures will be there. Don't worry for the figures. Please see, directly some angle will be matching to this. Y is matching to this one. So, we are getting one After that, we are getting X. After that, we are getting the Z from X. After that, you are getting C. Then you are getting A, linear pair. Then C opposite B. Then you are getting the figure nicely done. So, try to understand the sum. When this type of sums are there in your book, try to understand the sum. And please try to do the exercise sums nicely. And practice it nicely. Go for the theorems and prove it yourself. And by which it will be easier for you to solve the sums. For today, this is that much from lines and angles. In my next video, I will say you the next part of the lines and angles. Up to that, thank you very much. And